हेलो, दिस इज शिवानी पटेल वर्किंग एज अ रेगुलेटरी एग्जीक्यूटिव विथ मावन प्रोफकॉन सर्विसेज। टुडे वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट एस्टेब्लिशमेंट रजिस्ट्रेशन एंड डिवाइस लिस्टिंग एंड 510K नोटिफिकेशन टू एंटर योर डिवाइस इन US मार्केट। So starting with establishment registration, owners or operators whose place of business, which is also called as establishment or facilities that are involved in production and distribution of medical device intended for use in United States are required to register annually with FDA. So who is required to register? Manufacturers or remanufacturers, repackagers or relabelers, contract manufacturers or sterilizers, specification developers, reprocessors of single-use device, complaint handlers, and initial importers. Steps for registration. So for all establishment, whether it is a domestic or foreign establishment, following steps are to be followed, which includes paying annual registration user fees, followed by registering the establishment in FDA Unified Registration and Listing Systems, followed by providing information about the establishment, owner, operator, or official correspondent. The annual registration user fee for fiscal year 2021 is $5,546. Moving on to device listing, most establishments that are required to register with FDA are also required to list their device that are made there and the activities that are performed on those devices. If a device requires pre-market approval or notification before being marketed in the US, then the owner or operator should also provide the FDA pre-market submission number. Registration and listing provides FDA with the location of medical device establishment and the device manufactured at those establishments. Here is an example of establishment register which is done by Mavan Profcon Services. So moving on to 510K, what is a 510K? A 510K is a pre-market notification. The reason why a pre-market notification is also referred to as 510K is because it actually refers to Section 510K of the Federal Food, Drug and Cosmetic Act. It is a marketing clearance application and hence 510Ks are cleared. And FDA allows to determine the substantial equivalence of the device in order to submit a 510K. What is substantial equivalence? Comparing the device which is to be marketed to a similar or legally marketed device and support and make their substantial equivalence claim. Once the device is determined to be substantially equivalent, it can be marketed in the US. The substantial equivalence determination is usually made within 90 days and is based on the information submitted by the submitter. If FDA determines that the device is not substantially equivalent, then the applicant may resubmit another 510K with new data or request a Class 1 or Class 2 designation through the de novo application process, file a reclassification petition or submit a pre-market approval application. So who can submit a 510K? Domestic manufacturers who want to introduce their device in US market or specification developers or repackagers or relabelers who can make labeling changes or whose operation will significantly affect the device, and foreign manufacturers or exporters or their US representative who want to introduce the device in the US market. When is a 510K required? Unless exempted, introducing a device in commercial distribution for the first time, and if there is a change or modification to legally marketed device and that the change could significantly affect the safety and effectiveness of the device. Please note that FDA does not typically perform a 510K pre-clearance facility inspection. The submitter may market the device immediately after the 510K clearance is granted. The manufacturer should be prepared for a FDA quality audit at any time after 510k clearance. So this is a timeline that you can refer for your 510ks. However, this timeline depends upon the external factors also, and it may vary. So feeling lost as to how you compile your first 510k, we at Maven Profcon Services can help you with registering your establishment and listing your device with the 510k submission, comparing your product to the predicate device. We can help you in performance testing, biocompatibility testing, and we can also provide you the audit support. Thank you.